Hello everybody and welcome to Romancefull's Tarot. I'm about to begin here with this reading is designated to the sign of Leo. That being said, this is a general reading, so it might not resonate with everybody. So please do take whatever resonates with you and just leave the rest of it aside. If ever you would like to have your own personal reading, so you can contact me at romancefulltarot@gmail.com, and it will be my great pleasure to send you the different type of readings that I can offer you so we can go and find those answers that you're seeking for. That being said, if you have not yet subscribed to the channel and you are either new to the channel or you've been here many times, please do click onto the subscribe button to show your support to the channel and to myself. It is always greatly appreciated. So with no further ado, we're going to begin this reading. I have four different decks. So I have Angel Answers, Romance Angels, I have Work Your Light, and I also have the Lover's Oracle. So we're going to begin with the Lover's Oracle. The question at hand here that we want to know is, where is your relationship going? Okay, what is the future of your relationship? So let's go see. They're stuck together. Alrighty. And voila. So. Okay, so beware of what you are projecting. For the qualities you admire in one another are qualities you both possess. Now, equally so, the qualities you don't like are also your own reflection. Now that happens all the time. Sometimes we don't like somebody and there's really no good reason other than the fact that they remind us of us. Now, I also have deep in your heart, you already know the answer, do what feels right. So what is it that you're hiding? Are you hiding that you think this relationship is not going to go anywhere far and you're just not really saying anything because you're waiting for it to change? Or do you really think that it is going somewhere and you don't want to talk about it because you don't want to jinx the situation? There's different types of possibilities here with this card, but it really does mean exactly what it is that it says. Deep in your heart, you already know the answer, so do what is right. Do what is right with you, okay? You're the one who knows the best. I have imagined all unwanted thoughts dissolving into light, creating room for new opportunities and possibilities for your life. So this is really about just, you know, if you could just forget about every single thing, just have a blank card, would you do it? You have nothing to worry about. Nothing. You're starting with a blank page. Would you enjoy that or not? This is what the card is pretty much asking you to do. So, and it's going to end up with only time will tell. So I don't even have an answer for you. This is only time's going to tell, which means that you don't really know right now. They don't really know. So the cards cannot know. So that being said, for the meanwhile, try and do whatever it is that is best for you, how you're feeling comfortable into this relationship. I'm going to move over to the Romance Angels. Getting to know each other. As you reveal your innermost self to each other, your bonds deepen. So yes, it's very important to not just go onto surface, with our relationship, unless this is a relationship of convenience, which is not the case because this reading is not for that. But that being said, in any relationship, you're looking for deepening bonds is really what you're looking for at all times. So this is really about getting to know each other, getting to know each other better. And that is possible if we've been together for 1 year, 6 months, 2 years, 10 years, 20 years. There's always something to learn about your partner. So this is really about just strengthening your bonds by doing some activities together and learning about each other. I also have playfulness. So yes, you need to recapture romance. How do you do that? By having fun. Okay, so do whatever it is that you find fun. If it's going to the movies, if it's going for a bike ride, what do you find fun? What does your partner find fun? Because if you like going to, I don't know, the museum and your partner hates it, you're not working on the strengthening bonds here. So be very, very careful. Try and pick something that both partners do like, so that it will be helpful to begin with. And I have the card here just for you saying you are lovable, you deserve love. What a fantastic card to get, is it not? So, over here, I have first card, You need to compromise into your relationship, okay? Now, compromise, you're not always right, you're not always wrong. You kind of find yourself halfway in between, a little bit like we're doing here. We're doing the balancing game. You need to do the balancing game. So don't let your partner decide everything, and you can't decide everything also. It's all going down to sharing, let's put it that way, okay? So you're going to have to compromise. You're going to have to believe, okay? Let's not second doubt the relationship. Let's not second doubt the partner. Let's just believe, okay? And my final card is within the next few weeks. So you do even have a little timestamp here that within the next few weeks, things should be back on track. So as for the work your light, this is all about taking a leap, okay? So this is you go first, the universe will catch you. Now, life bends for the courageous. The universe wants to support you, but first you need to take the leap, to throw your life up in the air. Perhaps you know what you are being called to leap towards or away from, but are scared to make the move. So maybe perhaps you are waiting for a big fat sign or instruction manual or permission to do so first. And if this is so, then this card is your sign and permission to slip, to take a deep breath, and to leap into the unknown. So it's scary to let go all of what we know in hope for something new. And it's normal to feel anxious at the thought of letting go of what we know for sure. Both, this is an unavoidable process of rising, and a right now, this is how you are being called to live. Now, nature is constantly showing us to live with courage. Fall comes across year and encourages the trees to loosen their grip, to allow what once was so full of life to fall away leaf by leaf. For a moment, it feels like nothing will grow ever again. The branches are in the morn of spring, and the shoots begin to appear, and something new is born that is even more glorious than before. So this being said, this is your reading. I do hope that you enjoyed it. I do hope that you're able to apply to it, that you're able to resonate with it. If you would like to have your own reading, romancefulltarot@gmail.com. I do wish you a fantastic day, many blessings. Please don't forget to subscribe, and I will be seeing you soon with another reading for tomorrow. So thank you again for being there, and have a great day. Many blessings.